Brad Albrecht can run the baseline there.
Yes.
And then you create a better angle to make that inbound pass. But from where he threw it, the angle is so difficult when you have to run full speed and then to have to stop on the down. That's a tough, tough catch there by LeBert.
He did run the baseline a little bit. He cut to his left. It was a tough
and not allowed Tennessee to attack the rim.
Thompson to Stokes, the 7-7. Stokes and LeBert.
What? On Stokes. Wow. He called a charge.
He did? It's a fake out.
In that situation. I mean, great help defense there by LeBert. From that angle on where the official is, it looks like Stokes takes his shoulder directly into Morgan's chest. So that's a tough angle for him to have. In his mind, it's a charge. That's just a tough ball. And give Morgan credit, though, defensively.
That's the 16 foul. Albrecht with 6 seconds cannot run this baseline. And again, he needs help. Ball by Michigan.
I will say, Jim, I was surprised with the decision of Tennessee to go to Stokes.
See, the bomb.
Ow! It should be UT, right?
With 3.9 seconds.
Now that was a situation there where Thompson might have been better served to commit the foul. You almost did get the steal there. But right now, time is your enemy if you're Tennessee.
Albrecht again to inbound. Looking for Stauskas. And that is knocked out by Richardson. One official not sure who touched it last. I think this is going to be off Tennessee.
Yeah.
It's off Tennessee. Yeah, look back to that angle. But again, the two really good defensive plays by Tennessee have worked against them. Because you've got
Stauskas in the corner after 0.8 seconds.
Uh-oh.
And he got poked. There we go. Right across the nose. This will be a 1-1.
But the issue now, 2.1 seconds, it is really difficult to get that ball up into an area where you can get a good look. Remember, no timeouts for Tennessee now.
Tennessee, from this point, the win, and it's over the back corner.
Wow.